All right, this is the Double Eight Ranch in Elk Mountain, Wyoming. Owen and his crew invited us out to take a tour of using virtual fence to graze a set of cows along their willows. Here you can see where the cows are currently grazing, and then you can see an area ahead of them that they're getting ready to be turned into that hasn't been grazed yet. They're using Halter as the virtual fence application and collars that go on the cows to control where they're grazing. An interesting thing about their operation is they raise really high value hay and need to protect those meadows, keep animals out of those meadows, but want to be able to use the willows and the wooded areas throughout the summertime. So this is a tool that can be used to do that. And here's a set of cows and what they look like with the collars on. And Owen and his crew show a great example of using virtual fence as a tool to implement the grazing principles that we teach at Ranching for Profit.
So this tan colored is what we've previously grazed. They're currently in this white outlined break, and we'll move them to this blue shaded break today.
So this is where they're at today. I can click on that. It shows me that it's 12.9 acres. They've been there for 1 day, 19 hours, 58 minutes. Then this is the next move ahead of them, and it's, and we can either move them now or schedule it for any time.
What is your cost on it now?
$60 a head annually.
And that includes the tower?
No, tower is $3,500 a piece.
Okay.
And that was a
5-year contract on the tower.
It's like, that's, full warranty. I mean, they warranty everything. That's so, on one tower and 100.
That's only $7 per head per year on your tower. That's pretty much. I mean, really.
In one, and I think it would get off this tower on 100 head.
Yeah.
Get some more cows. With the cost of the collar and the cost of the towers over a 5-year contract, if I can increase our AUMs or grazing efficiency by 15%, it pays for it. And it will. Labor savings. So we look at grazing efficiency in the store. Growth, which are hard to manage. We've tried poly wire. When you got so much feed, and you guys know, you got so much feed in one place to utilize it well as a channel. So I know we could use it on infants. We've already tried that on some, and they're just a lot of grazing. We'll go show you. Corn stalks, I know there's a benefit to corn stalks. Mm-hmm. We've done that with poly too. And down there, we're not fighting wildlife, it's a labor concern. Yeah. You can only build
so much. Okay, so we'll select the pasture, select drop break, shift to next break. We can select the day we want to move them, what time, AM or PM. So just drop and shift now, then you hold to move.
Oh, they don't want you accidentally pushing the button. Right?
And then now they'll, in 12 minutes, they'll get the cue to move to the next break.
Oh, yeah.
Put it on, Chad.
No. I don't know.
Who's got the control?
Let me unpause it quick. Yeah.
So, Ryan will tell you how that feels.
Show me
everything we're looking at here.
So this is your solar panels, so it charges the batteries everywhere. You have an LED light here that you can trigger to see, like, if it collars off, you can trigger it to see it at night, or a set of cows, whatever you need to do. You have these steel ones right here. That's what shocks it. And then on this side, on either side, you have your speakers. It shows. Okay. That's what sends the sound. And then, yeah, you have your adjustable bands and the power rate on the bottom.
Just to keep everything above level. That's where all the weight
is. And we did notice that if you put them on too tight, we had a couple that we put on too tight when we first put them on. And so once they get sideways, there's not enough, like, room to for the counterweight to work. So it's like a fine line of putting them on loose enough that they're gonna, the counterweight will work.
And so any failure you've had is because it was too loose, not because of it breaking or getting caught somewhere.
None
of them have broke. It's just like we weren't quite sure how tight or how loose to go. Sure. And so we've had four soft pops. One on two pops. But you just run them through, catch their heads, strapped on.
So the sound is directional. So you put it on, the arrow goes to the body of the cat. And so if they're feeding into the boundary, it alerts them on this side and turns them. And if they turn, it goes off immediately. They're coming in both. And it sounds like a backup alarm. The closer you get, the more rapid the sound. And last night, there was a bull in the yard here. So the boundary was just across the fence. So he was on the gate was open because we were here. He was on the wrong side of the fence. So I went to walk him out of there. And I was close enough to him that I heard it. He was walking, and he walked into the virtual boundary, and it beat him. And he stopped and backed up. Like, I'm not messing. And then turned. He
went the other way.
Yeah. The first one that fell off.
Rylan knows where I'm going.
The first one that fell off, we packed it around. I was messing with the boundary. It was beeping, and I was listening to it. And I handed it to Corbin, and he did it. And Rylan grabbed it.
I was really messing with the beep. Just I turned my wrist left and right.
Oh, wow.
All of a sudden, it lit me
up. It's a good
it
shot.
Shocked system me. It bad cow. I heard it snap about 20 feet away. I mean, it already got it good.
So we bolt those things.
I don't know.
You ever been hit by an electric fence?
Oh, yeah.
Is it safe?
Oh, yeah.
Horse?
Probably about the same.
Same?
It just it caught me off guard.
Halter will tell you, it's just a light electric.
No, I bet.
So we were a little concerned about what that meant.
Yeah.
But after his reaction, it's enough.
Well, and the bull going, That's pretty good.
So now the 12 minutes has gone by, and the animals are getting a signal through the collar that the new paddock is available for use. Owen explained that they get a buzz when the new pasture is available and signals to them to start moving. He thought the main way they move is they observe the other animals. You'll see a couple animals are already in the new area. And now the energy of the herd starts to notice that animals are moving and which direction to go. And you can see the animals start to move to the new pasture.
So is it worth tearing fence out to implement the virtual fence?
I think it is. I think you tear it out eventually.
Economically, it'll pay for itself.
Yeah. And it's just so many benefits of being able to move where you want, when you want, how you want. I don't know about, you're shipping traps, and I'm struggling with that. Around here, we're getting close to shipping calves, or where you need some containment for calves, so you can find them when you need them. And I don't think you tear every fence off, but I think in the rangeland, a lot of the electric fence we put in, I think, will eventually come out if we adopt.
Wow.
So we're grazing on the west side of these windows. These go clear down to the south boundary.
So we had to come over to the east side to graze the willows over here. So we had a little patch of windrows in here, and you can see they clearly cleaned it up really well. And the very solid boundary here, you can see where the calves got into here. Cows stayed on this side.
And then on the north end, we got down to 3 acres along the fence over there that we were grazing in.
We slowly went from 40 to 15, and then to 10. 5 and then 3 acres, which is slowly contained them.
So we're looking at regrowth, 60 days of regrowth on a dry summer?
Yeah, so we set our boundary along the ditches to keep them off from trampling the ditches out.
There is enough water that was coming. It was irrigated enough that they didn't need the ditches for water because there was enough water throughout the whole pasture. So that's how we were able to water them, and then we were able to keep our infrastructure.
Why does the virtual fence work better in something like this than, say, polywire?
Wildlife. Wildlife's probably the biggest.
And your time, you can move them whenever you want with virtual fence, and you don't actually have to go up and put the wire or take it down or move it. So you can move them however many times a day you want. So.
How long does it take you to make the paddock for tomorrow?
30 seconds.
Yeah.
And yep. Schedule it for 5 o'clock tomorrow morning and
yep.
You're done.
Yep, you can schedule it for whenever, so.
Pretty significant time. Yeah, one of the biggest benefits I've seen, the most exciting thing that's hard to put an economic number to, is how excited the next generation is, the young kids, to manage cows.